This is part 12 of Logarithms, and in this video we solve the following two log equations. Alright, see if you could solve this one on your own first by putting the video on pause. Okay, we've got two logs with the same base added on the left side of the equation, so we combine that into one log using the product property. That's log base 6 of x minus 3 times x plus 2 equal to 1. So we have the log of something equals 1. So now we could use our definition, 6 to the first power equals this x minus 3 times x plus 2, or let's write it as x minus 3 times x plus 2 equals 6 to the first power. So now we've written it in exponential form, which will be a little bit easier. So on the right hand side, 6 to the first power is just 6. And on the left-hand side, well, we need to multiply those two binomials. You could do the FOIL method or any method you want. You have x squared plus 2x minus 3x minus 6. So we have x squared minus 6, x minus 6. Now, notice I have a 6 on the right-hand side. So at this point, let's just subtract 6 from both sides. So I have equals 0. Make sure you realize 1's a negative 6 on the left side and this is a positive 6. They don't cancel each other out. So I have x squared minus x minus 12 equals 0. And now we have a quadratic. So when you have a quadratic equation, hopefully you can factor it. That's the easiest way to do it. So let's go ahead and factor. X minus 4 times x plus 3 equals 0. And then we could set each of these factors equal to 0. So we have x equals 4, or x equals negative 3. And now we have to go back to the original problem before you did anything to it and make sure both of these solutions will check. All right, so we're ready to check. Let's check 4 first. Okay, so I'm just going to pick a note. I'm going to plug in 4 first. So I have log base 6 of 4 minus 3 plus log base 6 of 4 plus 2. So this gives me log base 6 of 1 plus log base 6 of 6. All right, now what's the log of 1? It's always 0 because anything, any base that's positive to the 0 power equals 1. So 6 to the 0 power equals 1, so that's 0, right? And what's the log of 6 base 6? Remember, when these numbers are the same, it's got to be 1 because 6 to the first power will equal 6, so that's just the number 1. So we have 0 plus 1 is 1, and that is what was on the right side. So that means that 4 is definitely a solution. It checked. Alright, now let's do negative 3. Well, what would happen if I plugged in negative 3 here for the x? There's a problem. I'd be taking the log of a negative number. So without going any further, I'm going to cross this off because I can't take the log of a negative number. You don't need to go through all that work. So the solution to this equation is 4. That's the only one that checked. Alright, here's the next one. This is a little bit trickier. Notice we've got logs on both sides, and if we didn't have this 2 added to the log of x, then we would just have x has to be equal 3 in this case, right? But we have a 2, so we're going to have to be a little bit more creative here. We need to get the logs on the same side of the equation, so we could use the product or the quotient rule. And it's up to you which side of the equation you put it on. Let's go ahead and put it on the right-hand side. So let's add log x to both sides. So if we do that, we would have the log of 3. I'm sorry, I meant to subtract log x from both sides. So this would be minus the log of x. Now also note, the base is not written, but that's okay because you know what that means. It means the base is 10. So we're getting closer. We've got the log of 3 minus the log of x. And now we can use the quotient property. That's the log of 3 over x. So remember, this is the base 10. So we said 10 to the second power equals 3 over x. Now, if it bothers you to see the log on the right-hand side, go ahead and just rewrite it this way. Right? You just put the two on the right, the other one on the left. It's the same equation. So we have 3 over x equals 10 squared. Remember, when you don't see the base, it means it's base 10. Okay. Now, 10 squared is 100. So I have 3 over x, and I'm going to write this as a proportion. 100 over 1. Because if you write it as a proportion, you could say the product of x and 100 is the same as the product of 3 times 1. So 100x equals 3. That's, of course, not the only way to solve this equation, but that's one way. And then just divide by 100. And that's what x is. Sorry, I wish it was easier, but it's not. It's 3/100. Or if you wrote that as a decimal, 0.03. So there's more than one way of writing that answer. Okay, I want to go back and redo it, putting the log on the other side before we check it. So remember, we got 3/100. And here's the original problem. So let's say you want to put the logs on the left side of the equation. Well, that's okay. That means you're going to subtract log 3 from both sides. And then you're going to have to subtract 2 from both sides. And so this is what it looks like. So now you have the log of x over 3 equals negative 2. Again, remembering that the base is 10, we'll have x over 3 equals 10 to the negative 2. And then you have to remember what that means. 10 to the negative 2 means 1 over 10 squared, which is x over 3 equals 1 over 100. So I hope you're seeing what's going to happen here. When you cross multiply again, right, you have proportion, you again are going to get 100x equals 3, or x equals 3/100, or 0.03. So it didn't matter if you put the logs on the left-hand side and worked it, or you put it on the right side and worked it. Now let's go ahead and check it. Okay, so here's the original equation. You have to do it in the original. So we have the log of, now, it doesn't matter if you write 3/100, or 0.03. I'm going to go ahead and just write 3/100. And now this, we can work two ways. You could use a calculator by putting in, let's see, of course it'd be easier in a calculator, just put the log of 0.03. So you put that in your calculator and you add 2, and what does that give? Well, you're going to get an approximation, so just keep in mind, at this point, it's not exact. The log of 0.03 is negative 1.522, and if you round it, it's going to be 9. So in other words, I'm just going to, you know, round that, and so then you have to add 2 to that, and you get approximately 0.4771. This is approximate. And then if you then go in your calculator and you look up the log of 3, it has the same approximation, 0.4771. So if you want to use your calculator, you can get, you know, pretty close, but sometimes you might be off somewhere, and that's because of the rounding. So to check this one, it isn't easy to do in your head. Now, there's tricky ways to do this without a calculator, and that is by rewriting 2 in terms of base 10. So just one more thing to see if you could follow this. So if you don't have a calculator, this is kind of tricky. Another way of writing 2 is the log of 100, right? Because 10 to the 2 power would equal 100. So if you wrote it like that, Then we could use the property of logs over here. By multiplying 100 times 300, that says the log of 3, and then you get the log of 3 on both sides. So that's a way of checking without really using your calculator, in case you don't have that on hand. But we did check it both ways, and our solution is 0.03, or if you want to write it in fractional form, it's 3/100.